Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this Google Tag Manager tutorial video, you're going to learn exactly how to set up Google Tag Manager so it shows up on every page of your WordPress site without using an extra plugin. Make sure you check out the links in the description to a timestamp table of contents, along with a full course on how to get up and running with Google Tag Manager. So once you're done with this video, you can get Google Analytics and your conversion tracking and your Facebook Pixel all set up and ready to go. Make sure you check that out after this video. So with that, let's go ahead and dive into my screen and get Tag Manager up and running. So first things first, we're gonna need to open up a Tag Manager account if we don't already have one. So you'd head over to just Google search, Google Tag Manager, and you'll be taken to a page that looks something like this, and you'll go ahead and click sign in or start for free. And if you're setting up your account for the first time, go ahead and choose the Gmail address or the G Suite address for your business or company. This should be one that you actually own. So if you work for someone else, or if you have a company account of a company that you don't own, please don't use that one. Use one that you 100% own for this. You can always be given access to other Google Tag Manager accounts in the future and share access, but you wanna make sure that when you set up your account, you own the email address that you're using. So once you've set it up and you've allowed access to Tag Manager, you're gonna go ahead and be taken to a page that looks like this, and we're going to create our account for our company. If you have multiple companies or you're going crazy with multiple projects, you can just repeat this process over and over again. We're just going to go through one sample company. So we're just going to give our account a name, and I'm in the US, so I'm going to leave it at US. It'll also give you the option to share data anonymously with Google and others. I generally don't click the box inside of Tag Manager. It's nice inside of Google Analytics because it gives you some comparative stuff, but there's no real advantage to doing it here. So once we've entered in our my awesome company name in the United States, we're gonna go ahead and give our container a name. Now what's cool is you don't actually have to use the exact URL. So if you have a lot of URLs you're gonna be putting in here, you can use any naming convention you want to keep track of them. Here, we're just gonna do supercoolcompany.com, and we're going to click use container as web. The other things are for apps, so we're not gonna be doing that. And we'll select web, and then we can go ahead and click create, and it's going to ask us to check that little data processing box at the bottom, and then we'll go ahead and click yes, and we'll be taken to a page that looks like this, where we'll be given our Google Tag Manager code. Now, if for any reason you accidentally click out of this and you're looking at your dashboard, you can always click on your Tag Manager ID and be taken back to this pop-up. So if you ever lose track, you can just click on that strange looking string of text and you'll be taken back here. So what we're gonna be doing here is we're going to need to place this code on our site. And so this is the code that we're gonna put on our site that's gonna replace all the other tracking codes. So what's really cool is once we put this in the head tag and the body tag, I'll show you how to do that in a second, we're never going to have to crack open the code of our website again. That's what makes Tag Manager so great. And to ensure we never have to break open the code of our site again, we need to make sure this code goes on every page of our site. Now, the good news is most page builders, especially with WordPress or the page builders like Lead Pages, you know, BuilderAll, ClickFunnels, they give you a place inside of your settings to place these two codes. So you're not gonna have to do any crazy HTML stuff unless you've done a custom site. And so whatever page builder you're using, you're going to want to look for something akin to theme options or page settings or analytics, scripts, and tracking. So I'm going to go through four examples here, two in WordPress, and then I'll show you where to find it inside of Shopify. So looking for analytics, tracking, or scripts, our first example here is the Thrive Themes plugin for WordPress. So I've gone to the Thrive dashboard and I've clicked on theme options down there on the bottom left. And then I've gone up to analytics and scripts. And you can see that there's a header script and an opening body script. And this is where we're gonna copy and paste that code. So you see there's code number one for the header and then code number two for the body. And all we have to do is copy and paste it in here. Now, if you've previously added tracking codes to your site before, there might be text already inside there. So what you're going to want to do is go ahead and scroll to the bottom and then click enter a couple times and then paste in your Tag Manager code. Because once Tag Manager is installed on your site and you're ready to go, you're gonna delete all those other codes because you're gonna take those codes and put it into Tag Manager. I know that can sound a little confusing, but don't worry, we're gonna go step by step here. So that's number one. So example number two is the Thrive plugin. So I'm in the Thrive dashboard and I've gone to just my dashboard settings and I've scrolled down to a selection for landing pages, analytics scripts, and tracking. I'm just going through these examples so you kind of get a sense of where to look for your settings in your own software. And once I click on this, I'll be taken to a place where I can add a new script. So you can see here, there's a drop-down menu, before head and after head. So red is the header text. I'd go ahead and paste it in here and I'd say before header, and then I'd go ahead and do this process over again, and I'd click after body for the green text of the tracking code that goes in the body. Now, hopefully this is giving you some insight into where to look in your own software. Second to last example here, inside of OptimizePress, I've just gone to the dashboard and you can see they have an analytics and tracking section and two spaces for the code to just be copied and pasted in there. So hopefully one of these three examples is close to the type of software or plugin or theme that you're using. And once you've pasted that code into your site and you've clicked save, it's time to make sure that it actually was added correctly. And for this, Google has a free tool for us called Google Tag Assistant. It's a free Chrome plugin. So what we'll do is we'll just go to Google and search Chrome Tag Store Assistant or Google Tag Assistant, and we'll be taken, just go ahead and click on the first option for the web Chrome store, and we're going to be able to install this free plugin. And what's really cool is this actually works on any site. So if you want to check out your competitors and what they're using and what tags they have on their site, it'll actually work on their site as well. So once we click add to Chrome, we're going to go ahead and click done. Just leave everything checked. You can always remove settings later, but more is better here. It's just more free data. And then we'll go ahead and go over to our site and click on it. And you'll notice that it's going to say it's currently not enabled. So we're going to need to click enable. And then once we refresh the page, we'll be able to see our tag manager code along with all the other tags we're going to be adding in the future. So in this particular example, you can see here we have tag manager and we have an AdWords remarketing tag on the site. Since you just installed tag manager, all you should see is Google Tag Manager unless you already have other tags that are lingering around someplace. Now you'll notice there's some yellow arrows at the bottom. We're going to ignore that for this tutorial because I'm purposely blocking myself on a site that we actually own, but we'll go through what red and green means. So obviously red is bad and green is good. Now, if you see anything with red, that doesn't necessarily mean the tag isn't working. I know this can really trip a lot of people up. So what you want to do is click on the tag that's showing red and then look at the errors. And most of the time, the errors aren't going to make any sense. In this particular instance, you see it's error blocked by client. That's because I'm using a plugin to block myself so I don't cookie and pixel myself in our own marketing or marketing for our clients. However, if there's something else here, you can go ahead and type that into Google and you're going to be able to go through Google Forms and find out what the problem is relatively quickly. A lot of the errors have a code, so it's very easy to figure out what the issue actually is. For our example here, Google Tag Manager is green, so that means we are good to go. Google Tag Manager is on our site correctly, and we're now ready to move on to adding other tags inside of Tag Manager to really take advantage of all of the tag benefits Tag Manager offers us.
Thank you for watching. I hope you found this video informative and actionable. If you got some value out of this video, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more in-depth marketing tutorials just like this one. If you have any tag manager problems, comment below. I read and reply to every single one. And of course, until the next video, keep building the business you love.